my dear friends, welcome to my channel HSR BioInfo. In today's class, we are going to discuss an important organelle of cells, that is the endoplasmic reticulum. Which is simply called as ER, endoplasmic reticulum. Actually, initially, the endoplasmic reticulum first identified by a scientist called as a Garnier in the year of 1895. After 1895, scientist Porter and Claude found the ultrastructure of endoplasmic reticulum in the year of 1945. After 1945, in the year of 1953, Porter named this organelle as endoplasmic reticulum. Actually, endoplasmic reticulum name given by the Porter, initially identified by the Garnier. And after that, ultrastructure was identified by the Porter and Claude. This is all about the background. Actually, see, the endoplasmic reticulum. What is meant by endoplasmic reticulum? Endo means inside, plasm means cytoplasm, whereas reticulum means it's a matrix. A matrix of organelle structure that is present in the cytoplasm, especially inside of cells, such called as endoplasmic reticulum. So this is a simple definition for the endoplasmic reticulum. Let us see what is the endoplasmic reticulum. Actually, endoplasmic reticulum, which is formed by the three elements, those includes cisternae, tubules, vacuoles. Cisternae, tubules and vacuoles. So let us see how cisternae are formed, tubules are formed and vacuoles are formed in the cell. So we know very well, actually let us see, this is cell, the cell that contains nucleus. Is it right? Nucleus. Here I am going to draw this nucleus part, that contains the double layer membrane. Nucleus also that contains the nuclear pores. So let us see. So this is the nucleus. This nucleus, the internal membrane and outernal membrane, two membrane structure is the nucleus. In this internal membrane and outernal membrane, the outernal membrane that forms the structures called as cisternae. Like this. You can also draw here. Similarly, you can hear here, here. So, what it is showing? External membrane of nucleus that converted into the cisternae. Again, the cisternae that forms into a many branches like structures. Like this. So, such type of structures we called as a tubules. Here also same. Like this. So, these two structures are very important here. Actually, the tube-like structures, here is a very branched one, here is no branches. Here is branches, here are no branches. That is the difference. Here, unbranched structures we called as a cisternae. Whereas, branched structures we called as a tubules. So, let us see. The main important function and main important structures of endoplasmic reticulum. Here, the cisternae of endoplasmic reticulum that contains or that shed by the many number of structures called as a ribosome. So, this cisternae that containing ribosomes. Similarly here. So on, like this. So, what happens? Cisternae that contains the ribosomes, the tubules that doesn't have the any ribosomes on its surface. Now, the third element of endoplasmic reticulum is of vacuoles. See, vacuoles are the components or shed of components of cisternae and tubules. Vacuole like structures, these vacuoles looking like a spherical. These looking like spherical, these structures pinched out from the cistern and tubules of endoplasmic reticulum. Here also, the spherules which are came from the cistern that contains the ribosomes on its surface. Whereas, the cisternae, the vacuoles which are came from these tubules that doesn't have any ribosomes on its surface. So, this is major important differences between the cisternae and tubules. What are the spherules they are coming from this region and what are the spherules they are came from these tubules. So, now the main important concept is, see, the spherical cisternae that contains the ribosomes on its surface and looking like very rough in nature. The surface area of these particles looking very rough due to the presence of the ribosomes on its surface. But the tubules that doesn't have any organelles on the surface, so it is looking like a smooth. So based on these criteria, endoplasmic reticulum can divide into two important types. One is the rough endoplasmic reticulum. simply called as a RER. And the second one is a smooth endoplasmic reticulum, simply called SER. Rough endoplasmic reticulum, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So, in this way, the complete structure of endoplasmic reticulum is present. Now, the important thing is the endoplasmic reticulum, especially rough endoplasmic reticulum, is very near to the nuclear membrane. Is it right? Very near to the nuclear membrane, whereas the smooth endoplasmic reticulum in the form of tubules, that is very near to the where actually plasma membrane. This is a very important. Very important. The spherical structures formed here are more in the rough endoplasmic reticulum, whereas vacuoles, which are very less in the tubules, that is a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. This is all about the rough and smooth endoplasmic reticulum and the elements which are present in the endoplasmic reticulum and ribosomes which are associated with the rough endoplasmic reticulum, whereas smooth endoplasmic reticulum that doesn't have any ribosomes on its surface. Okay, it is clear. Now, we can look at the functions of the rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Let us start with the rough endoplasmic reticulum, RER, rough endoplasmic reticulum. Actually, the main important function of rough endoplasmic reticulum is only protein synthesis. And protein foldings. Protein synthesis and protein folding. How the rough endoplasmic reticulum, which is forming protein synthesis and protein foldings. So let us see, actually rough endoplasmic reticulum that contains the ribosomes on its surface. Is it right? For example, you just assume this is a endoplasmic reticulum that contains the ribosomes. These ribosomes actually that binds to the mRNA, which is came from the transcription of cell. For example, here is the DNA. DNA is a double stranded. The double stranded DNA that converted into the single stranded mRNA. This single stranded mRNA is converted into the polypeptide. So, here the mRNA which is bound by the ribosomes which are present in the endoplasmic reticulum, especially rough endoplasmic reticulum. Let us see, ribosomes here that binds to the mRNA of cell. This mRNA of cell that converted into the polypeptide with the help of the tRNA, transfer RNA. So, all these concepts and mechanism I will discuss in the upcoming classes. Right now, we have to understand why and how polypeptide or protein synthesis. Polypeptide means protein. That protein is synthesized by the ribosomes, which is occupied on the surface of endoplasmic reticulum. Now, the mRNA which is bind here and which forms the a protein or a polypeptide, a linear chain actually. It is not a complete protein, it is a linear chain. A chain that contains the amino acids, different top 20 amino acids that are arranged randomly in the polypeptide chain based on the mRNA sequence. Okay, now this polypeptide which is synthesized by the ribosomes present on the endoplasmic reticulum, that is called as a protein synthesis, simply called synthesis of protein. Now, actually what we have, the protein, the polymer of amino acids. These amino acids which is present in the linear, that linear structure we called as a primary protein. Primary protein or primary peptide. Now, these primary peptide that converted into the secondary structure, that is called as this linear structure that converted folded into like this. In this, there are two types of helix and sheets are formed based on the amino acid composition which are present in these polypeptide that forms the two types of secondary architecture of the protein that is called as helix and sheets. It means there are sheet-like structure based on the amino acid composition, they forms the sheet-like structures. So, these are the sheets, the rest of the part is the helix. Helix means that forms like this. Sheet means that forms like this in the secondary structure of the protein. These secondary structure of protein that finally converted into the tertiary structure, that is so three-dimensional structure, 3D structure, that is forms like this. All these structures of primary secondary structures that convert into this protein, these type of conversions from the single linear structure to the secondary structure and 3D structure, that is done by the endoplasmic reticulum. This entire mechanism, this entire process we called as the protein foldings. The protein foldings, that is a primary linear to the helix and sheets to the 3D structure of protein. So, in this way, these endoplasmic reticulum, especially rough endoplasmic reticulum, done these two important functions. Now, after folding, which are done in the endoplasmic reticulum, this endoplasmic reticulum adjacently associated with the one more organelle that is called as a Golgi apparatus. Golgi apparatus. These are the Golgi complex. I will discuss these Golgi complex functions and structures in the next coming class. And what we have to understand here, the endoplasmic reticulum folded protein shed off from the vacuole-like structure in the endoplasmic reticulum to the Golgi complex. Actually, Golgi complex is formed by the endoplasmic reticulum. So, now these folded structures that enter into the Golgi complex, where the different functions of Golgi complex will occur, finally it reaches to the target site of cell. This protein will reaches after processing by the Golgi complex, this protein reaches to the target sites like plasma membrane, any site. So, in this way, protein folding can done by the rough endoplasmic reticulum. This is clear. Now, coming to the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Actually, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, we have discussed, that is very adjacent to the plasma membrane. Actually, let us see the smooth endoplasmic reticulum functions. The first function of smooth endoplasmic reticulum is lipid synthesis. That is involved in the lipid synthesis and which is essential for the synthesis of steroidal hormone, which is involved in the detoxification. Which is essential for the desmosomes formation. So, detoxification, steroidal hormone synthesis and lipid synthesis, detoxification and desmosome formation. So, all these functions can done by the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Especially, it is present in the muscle cell as a sarcoplasmic reticulum. sarcoplasmic reticulum. So let us see each and every functions a little bit detail. So lipid synthesis, actually the lipids, whatever the food we are taken through the different oils and whatever the things, that food is absorbed by the intestinal villi and that reaches to the many sides of the body, where the adipose tissue, which is stores the what, the lipid content. We know very well that lipid is stored in the adipose tissue. In the adipose tissue, adipocytes are present. Such adipocytes that contains the huge number of smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Such smooth endoplasmic reticulum which forms the lipid storage through the process called as a lipid synthesis. Through the process called as a lipid synthesis. Coming to the synthesis of steroidal hormones. Synthesis of steroidal hormone. We know very well steroidal hormones are very essential for the many functions in the body. For example, testosterone, which is present in the leading cells of testes, and also estrogen, progesterone, which is also present in the female reproductive organs. Okay, follicular cells that produces these steroidal hormones, and also adrenal glands, they produces the steroidal hormones. So all these places that is smooth endoplasmic reticulum is more abundantly present and which is responsible for the synthesis of steroidal hormones. If smooth endoplasmic reticulum is very less, there is no storage of lipids and there is no need of steroidal hormones. So such places are many in our body. Coming to the detoxification. Detoxification, that means anyone, whatever the food we are taking that contains a little bit of the toxicants. Is it right? Sometimes we are intaking the spoiled food. Such type of food that contains some toxicants which is released by the pathogenic bacteria, virus, whatever that food contains. So here detoxification is a process where the chemicals or any drugs which are present in our food or which are intaken by the human beings are detoxified by the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, which is abundantly present in the liver, where actually detoxification occurred in the liver cells. That liver cells detoxification is occur and which is done by a process called as a detoxification, where actually any drug that doesn't dissolve in the water, such type of drugs or such type of toxicants, which is, for example, a drug A that doesn't dissolve in the water and doesn't move into the urinary system and from where to the outside. So such type of drugs or any toxicant which is added by the OH group by the cells of the liver cells, hepatocytes, such cells which forms the OH groups on the toxicants, that converts hydrophobic nature into the hydrophilic nature. That means this type of OH group contains a toxicant that dissolved in the water. Such dissolved toxicant that enter into the urinary system, from where it releases through the urine into the outside. So such type of process we called as a detoxification. This process is done in the liver by the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So liver contains more abundant amount of smooth endoplasmic reticulum. That is should be understood. Next, desmosomes. The desmosomes are the connections which are present in between the two cells. Actually, let us see, here is a cell, the cell that adjacent to the another cell. These cells, two cells that is interconnected by a tube-like structures called as a desmosomes. These desmosomes are occupied, or these desmosomes run through the
A organelle called as a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. These tube-like structures will allow this cell A into this cell and cytoplasm from one cell to the another cell. They exchange both cells cytoplasm through the desmosomes. Now, these desmosomes are formed by the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. I already mentioned the smooth endoplasmic reticulum in the form of tubules which are very adjacent to the plasma membrane. Is it right? The plasma membrane, this is a plasma membrane that contains the smooth endoplasmic reticulum that also run through the one cell into the another cell through the desmosomes. This is very essential function for the cell growth and also cell survival. Now coming to the sarcoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum, especially smooth endoplasmic reticulum that is present in the muscle, very very important. The endoplasmic reticulum that is present in the muscle cells, that is called as a sarcoplasmic reticulum. Sarcoplasmic reticulum, especially this sarcoplasmic reticulum which is involved in the muscle contraction. This muscle contraction is associated by the calcium release. So, this calcium release also associated with the sarcoplasmic reticulum. During the muscle contraction, there are some proteins which is essential for the muscle contraction. Whenever we receive the signal from the outside of cell, then the cell get contrast. The signal which induces some signal into the cell, that signal that contains that induces the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. This smooth endoplasmic reticulum very rich and it contains the high amount of the calcium ions. Now whenever the signals we received, the signal which induces the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, then it releases the calcium ions. These calcium ions are bind to some proteins. Then after the muscle contraction will be occur. So this is what about the smooth endoplasmic reticulum functions. So the two major important functions of rough endoplasmic reticulum is the protein synthesis and protein foldings. And smooth endoplasmic reticulum functions are the lipid synthesis and steroidal hormone synthesis and detoxification, desmosomes formations and also sarcoplasmic reticulum. In this sarcoplasmic reticulum that is essential for the storage of the calcium, that storage calcium is released by the signal whenever the muscle get contrast. So in this way, smooth and rough endoplasmic reticulums are very essential for the cell survival and also cell functions. Okay, so along with this, there is a one more word to be noted, Nissen's granules. These Nissen's granules present in the neurons, those neurons that contains the Nissen's granules are the mass of endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum mass which is present in the neurons, such mass of endoplasmic reticulum we called as the Nissen's granules. So, in this complete topic, we have to understand which one of the endoplasmic reticulum essential for the protein folding and synthesis and also which causes the especially detoxification, very important, lipid synthesis also very important, also muscle contraction, this giving muscle contraction, which one of the endoplasmic reticulum which is involved in the muscle contraction, definitely that is a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So in this way, this is the organelle which is present in the cytoplasm from the nuclear membrane to the up to the plasma membrane. So this is called as a endoplasmic reticulum. I hope this is a very clear to understand. So if you really understood this concept very clearly, please do subscribe my channel HSR Bioinfo. Don't forget to like and comment. Thank you very much for your patience.